Bill Nye the Science Guy.
I'm a girl. Could have just as easily been a boy, though, because the probability of becoming a girl is always 1 in 2. See, inside each of our cells are these things called chromosomes, and they control whether we become a boy or a girl. Your mom has 2X chromosomes in all of her cells, and your dad has 1X and 1Y chromosome in each of his cells. Before you're born, your mom gives you one of her chromosomes and your dad gives you one of his. Mom always gives you an X. And if dad gives you an X too, then you become a girl. But if he gives you his Y, then you become a boy. See, there are only two possibilities. There are only two possibilities. There are only two possibilities.
There are a few things out there that confuse people as much as gender. The main misconception is that it's the same as sex. Boys have a penis, girls have a vagina. Sex is a spectrum of femaleness to maleness. Anyone who doesn't fall neatly into male or female is intersex, but that's a different video. Gender, on the other hand, is determined by your culture. Gender is made up of things like gender roles that are assigned to you based on your sex. In the United States, we have 2 official genders, man and woman, but in other parts of the world, like Thailand and Indonesia, there are 3 genders, 4 genders, even 5. For instance, Bisu refers to being all genders in Sulawesi, Indonesia. Ultimately, they've just expanded the number of social categories that people can identify with. Now, back here in the States, feminists and activists have been moving society to think outside the box. Brush that gender binary. Why should man or woman be our only options, and why shouldn't you get a say in it? There has been some progress. Last year, Facebook changed their gender identity terms from 2 to 51.
I know that so many people are starting to catch this SJW virus, but I never knew that it would be my dearest Bill.
Cuck. Cuck. Cuck.
Bill, 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 Bill.
Save the world. Save the world.
Bill, 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 Bill.
Save the world.
Now this. This is AIDS.
Right, why are we here, Vanilla?
Damn!
Oh, this again? Come on!
That's me right now. I'm smiling, but I'm actually dead inside.
Chillax, Strobs!
Settle, everybody. Settle. Now, I've spoken to some of you about my theories on the nature of being ice cream.
Which have no basis in science.
It's the science of feeling.
I'm assuming they're talking about sexuality here, where Vanilla is straight. This is not a science of feelings, this is just common sense.
And as Vanilla, I feel that I am the most natural of the ice creams.
I don't want to be like the party pooper here. Technically, being straight enables you to reproduce, fertilize an egg with a sperm that is natural. You can't reproduce something with 2 dicks or fucking...
And therefore, the rest of you should just go ahead and also be Vanilla.
Oh!
It's the one true flavor.
No! Don't make me stop being strawberry delicious!
Oh, Christ.
So you have Vanilla that's straight. One of the flavors then has to be a lesbian. One of them has to be gay. One of them has to be bisexual. Okay, someone over here is a fucked up ice cream. Someone over here has a made up sexuality.
Can you stop being strawberry, Strawberry?
You're Strawberry! Hold me, salted caramel!
I just think if you want to get right with the big ice cream in the sky, change your flavor by wishing to be Vanilla.
What if the big ice cream in the sky is chocolate?
Blasphemy! Everyone should pretend to be Vanilla until they no longer have the urge not to be Vanilla.
I did not urge to be pistachio. I am pistachio. Hey, mint chocolate chip!
Sorry I'm late. I was busy being 2 awesome things at once.
Okay, nope, Choco Chip is obviously bisexual. This is weird.
Cool!
Just in general, why are we advertising the fact that bisexuality is cool? If you're bisexual, you're bisexual, that's absolutely great. If you're straight, you're straight, that's great. If you're gay, you're gay, that's great too. But none of it is meant to be like a fashion craze or a trend or something that's cool, okay? It's not. This provides people with pressure, and it also makes people take bisexuality less seriously.
Not cool. Pick a lane, Buttstain.
Vanilla's trying to convert us all again.
That's nuts. No offense, nuts.
12 seconds later.
Come on, Vanilla. Nobody wants just one flavor of ice cream.
I do.
Haven't you ever wanted to be in a Neapolitan?
I can't.
Come on, it's natural. All natural cocoa.
And strawberry fresh from the field.
It's so creamy and delicious. Mmm.
What am I even watching? Bisexual mint ice cream here is pressuring vanilla ice cream into a threesome, foursome, gangbang, whatever you want to call it. Isn't that some form of sexual assault here? Can someone enlighten me?
Meet you at the ball.
This is on.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, get it. Woo!
Get in here, nuts.
Can we not encourage gangbangs, please? Can we teach people a bit of decency? Having a gangbang is not something to be proud of. Again, this is exactly how STDs spread. Being slutty is not cool.
Guys, seriously, this next thing I feel is very special. This is a cool little segment. You know this woman from Crazy Ex-Girlfriend. Please give it up for Rachel Bloom.
This one goes out to all my bipeds who identify as
ladies.
You don't identify as a gender, please stop. Unless you are actually going under some sort of gender reassignment surgery, having hormone therapy, or have gender dysphoria, then please stop labeling yourself as something you're not.
Cause my sex junk is so much more than either.
Also, wo haben sie die aufgebuddet? Look, it's bad enough that they had such extreme budget cuts that they had to hire this talentless piece of shit. But they also hired dancers that looked like they got the place in an online competition.
Versatile love may have some butt stuff.
Ew. Do you want your anal muscles to be so loose that shit literally falls out of your rectum? Because that is what butt stuff does, okay?
It's evolution, ain't nothing new.
Butt stuff is not evolution.
Give someone new a handy.
Give someone new a handy. I'm sorry, but where is the self-respect here?
My sex junk's better than bagels with lox. With lots of schmear.
Oh, no. No. Mm-mm. What is this?
Exactly the right message, Rachel.
Nice job.
Wait, what? Oh, yeah, that's definitely the right message, guys. This is why aliens won't visit us. Because this.
Save the world.
Bill, 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 Bill.
Save the world. Save the world.
Yes, that Facebook post is actually mine, as is this candid post. And the thing is, you haven't even seen the entire ice cream skit cartoon thing. I mean, you didn't even see the part where Vanilla was actually corrupted or convinced into that gangbang orgy. It just pisses me off so much. Originally, I didn't make an appearance in this video at all. My voice was nowhere to be found in it. That last section I just threw on for some added clarity to that Facebook post. You see, this video was originally intended to just be a high-edited compilation of what everybody else has to say about the Bill Nye fiasco, and I would only add in a few things with how I edited things, how I presented the information, and some text that I add on. So imagine my surprise when, after editing this video all day, and it's about 12:45 when my video was finally uploaded to YouTube, that about a millisecond after it was uploaded, Netflix took it down with a copyright strike. So I stopped my liquid metal slime hunting in Dragon Quest VIII to try and find the problem with my video. I went to the 8:37 minute mark and watched to the 11:40 minute mark, as that is the time that Netflix claims is their own copyrighted content. And sure enough, they were absolutely correct. They were right to take down my video from a copyright standpoint, but I think it hurts them more than they realize. In the interest of fairness, I wanted to give Bill a chance to defend himself, and let you, the audience, decide for yourself which was more feasible. I wanted to do this without me or anyone else in this video butting in, so I just wanted to use some very minorly edited, on my part, clips from Bill Nye Saves the World, a Netflix-owned property. But I'm afraid I just can't do that. Links for the Abacus of Sex are in the description. You have to go watch it for yourself.
Now, we're going to be talking about gender today, because he's making the case that gender exists on a spectrum. By the way, very different. If you go back to his old show, he did say that chromosomes determine gender. If you go back to the episodes when we were kids. So he's done a 180
amazing
on that.
Amazing how 2017 just changes science.
Yeah. Completely changes science. Also used another example going down the trail, which I haven't heard a lot of people bring up, but he brings up the clownfish. And he says, are you aware that the clownfish can change his sex? Okay, my dog licks his balls. How is this relevant to the idea of biological sex or gender? Next, Bill Nye is saying maybe some doctors now believe that it's possible with the brain issue. Well, again, science. Bill Nye, isn't the burden of proof at that point on you? Science is hypothesis, test it, conclusion. He's testing nothing and coming to the conclusion that now gender is on a spectrum because feeling. And of course, the big irony that Jared has brought up and several guests have talked about, if there's this idea that there can be a male brain and a female brain, and this is the basis on which modern sort of gender identity is predicated, right? Well, actually, someone can be, the wrong brain can be born into the wrong body, a female brain and a male body. Well, it blows up the entire hypothesis to begin with, because we've since said that gender is a social construct. Well, gender can't be a social construct if someone is born with a wrong brain, which you are saying is biologically a male brain and a female brain. Even more so if we're using it as a constant. If we are saying there is such a reliable format for what a male brain looks like and a female brain, that there is an anomaly and an outlier with transgender or gender dysphoria people, that it's clear they're born with the wrong brain. Again, that has to be so remarkably consistent that gender couldn't possibly be a social construct. But Bill Nye simply wants to say the science of feelings, gender exists on a spectrum. And that's why he's Bill Nye, the not-so-sciencey, douchebag, arrogant guy.
Bill Nye the
censorship
guy.
Bill Nye the censorship
guy. Bill Nye the
censorship
guy.
Censorship.
Rules.
Censorship.
Supreme victory.
Well, I stumbled upon an article on freebeacon.com that was saying that the episode on Bill Nye the Science Guy on Netflix that was had the segment saying that the genders are determined by chromosomes had been omitted. It was just taken out. And this is the segment that I use in my video because this is what we know to be true. There's two genders and they're determined by the chromosomes. Something that he said himself as well.
Before you're born, your mom gives you one of her chromosomes and your dad gives you one of his.
I had to check it out myself just to confirm the insanity.
So normally after that segment of consider the following, it's supposed to jump right into that segment of that girl talking about the X and XY chromosomes that determine your gender. But it's just gone. It just goes to this Volkswagen, him pulling up in the bug. And it's confirmed, man. This is incredible.
I mean, what's happening? You know, it's one thing if Bill Nye has genuinely changed his mind about this, whatever, but it's just another thing to just go out of your way and to censor like a 20-year-old show. I mean, that's fucking insane to me. Like, you're censoring history. That is, like, I hate to use the word fascism, but that's kind of what we'd expect from a fascist regime, you know, to just be like, we don't like this, fucking censor it all. We don't like this art. We don't like this science. Fuck it. Now, one thing I want to say is that Netflix have come out and said that they did not have anything to do with this. So it's definitely Bill Nye or Disney, because you know Disney is all about the LGBTQ A plus G X Y Z pound sign or whatever. And it shows, and you know, Netflix is like, oh, this is a shitstorm. Let's stay out of this. And it looks like it's probably only getting weirder.
So Facebook recently removed a user's photo because it had nudity in it. Specifically, we're talking about titties. Girls' titties. So Facebook sends user this message. Your photo was removed for displaying nudity. We removed one of your photos because it doesn't follow the Facebook community standards. We created our standards to help make Facebook a safe place for people to connect with the world around them. Please read the Facebook community standards to learn what kinds of posts are allowed on Facebook. If you think your photo shouldn't have been removed, you can reply to this message with more information and we'll review the photo again. If it doesn't go against our community standards, we'll restore it to Facebook. So user replies with, "She identifies as a man, so technically her nipples should be acceptable on this page." Then Facebook responds with what looks like an auto-response, "We'll take another look at the photo and let you know when we have an update." And then they follow up with, "Thanks for your patience, user. It looks like your photo does follow our community standards, so we're restoring it to Facebook now. We're sorry for the confusion, and we appreciate you asking us to take another look. Feedback like yours will help us prevent this kind of mistake as we work to keep the Facebook community safe in the future. Thanks again for your help and understanding. How was this experience?" Feedback like yours will help us prevent this kind of mistake. Yeah, because next time they'll have absolutely no problem distinguishing between some girl's tits and the tits of some other girl who identifies as a man. Fucking brilliant. But seriously, how fucking retarded is that? Now, I'm not saying the titties should be taken off Facebook, the more the merrier. But how the fuck does it change things if the owner of those titties identifies as a man? They're the exact same titties. The dumbest part is that in their effort to be all sensitive and understanding and shit, Facebook have just given feminists a reason to piss and moan about double standards. I urge you, go to Facebook and post your titties there. And when they try to remove those titties, you tell them that you identify as a man. Because I just know, deep down in my heart, that if we can get heaps of titty photos on Facebook, it'll be really fucking funny. Thanks for watching.